is supposed to the male and female saddle by right has a little bit of different width. Right, this is supposed to go to your hip bone, the W part. Right, so the W part is actually sitting on the sweet spot. So you can decide your sweet spot is where, but normally it's kind of in the middle of this round thing over thing. Right, so this wave is kind of this one. Right, then female, especially after birth, this one tends to be a bit wider. So you should find a saddle that fit you. How to find the wave is to use a fresh aluminum foil, kitchen aluminum foil, put it on a relatively hard surface and sit on it, and then come out and then find where is the 2 point and then measure. That will be your hip bone, your saddle selection. Then you should sit there, and then your leg, where to put? Some people heel strike, no heel strike. It's because some people ride like that, some people ride like that, some people ride like that, some people ride. Like the correct way, if you use a clipless Shimano shoe and all that, it is actually right the middle of your big bone here. I don't know what bone you call this. Any medical people here? Alright, this should be in the middle of your axial. That should be how you ride, and your leg should be parallel. With certain degree of maybe 2-3-5 degree. So the creep got color, yellow color, blue color, all these, is how much angle you can turn. So when you go into a clipless system, you should go like that. Like Eugene, can you sit on it and then make sure your big bone is right in the middle, your top is at the right, at the sweet spot, and then balance yourself. I think I want to protect your...
Yeah, so that's like,
that's it. And then here, move to a 3 o'clock position. Too much. A bit more. Okay. These are the right position. Alright. Top, okay, ready? Okay, Here, okay? Okay, So, the thing to look for is actually your this do not exceed your toe. That's the only thing you want to really be careful. Because once you exceed your toe, you are overarching as you press, it's bad for you. So to avoid injury, that's where you want to look at. This can be adjusted by a couple of things. One is the saddle height. When the saddle height go higher, this one go to be that way, right? So this will not be here, you'll be in. Two is the saddle position. You can adjust your saddle position back a bit so that it doesn't touch. So things to look for simple bike fitting. Now the other way to look at this is use your heel, right? Go all the way down. You straighten your leg. Your heel, a bit more. Somewhere like that, it should be kind of straight. That is another method. But at the end of the day, you must be comfortable. Alright, so this is adjusting your the main thing to look out is knee cannot exceed toe, not shoe. And then no overarching. And most of the time ended up is a tiptoe position as you stop, it's a tiptoe position. Right? Most of the time. Then after you adjust all this, then the next thing is the reach of the handlebar from yourself to the handlebar. So if you go for professional bike fitting, they use a gauge, I can't remember 34 or something to put here, and then from here you measure to the center of your handlebar, that is the reach. We are not doing that. So reach and all that is, end of the day you are comfortable, no pain, no shoulder ache, right? And do not lock your elbow, alright? It should be a little bit more relaxed position, right? And then use your core a bit more. Right, you have to use your core to support your body instead of whole day resting, doing push-up. This is doing push-up as you ride. So your shoulder ache normally is because of push-up, because your whole body weight is resting on it. So to overcome this, of course, you can bring your handlebar higher, nearer, so that to relieve the pain. But the main thing is your core muscle, you have to train your core muscle. So at the end of the day, a rope fight tends to be the saddle height is almost the same height as your handlebar. Road bike is almost like that. Good position. And that one is a little bit more aggressive because you have a drop bar, right? A little bit more arrow so that you can go faster. The whole idea is to go faster, la, not to relax, to go faster. So you want a little bit more arrow and then you go this way. And your arm is flexed, not locked. Never lock your, try to learn and you cycle, remind yourself, don't lock. Sometimes bend a bit, you relax your right.
So you want more control about steering and all that. So it's more relaxed.
Ah, correct.
Shoulders back.
Correct.
This way.
Correct.
So they can.
Yeah, correct. So it's not pushing the bike all the way.
You have a bit of free play.
Correct. It should be a relaxed position. It must always be a relaxed position.
Sorry,
I'm late.
Yes.
CS.com. Oh, you say you're not right, putting it upright. Yeah. Okay, it's okay lah. You still pay. So we're just going through the bike fitting. Alright, so and then of course you can also play with the width lah, because as go wider you have to go lower, right? So it's a little bit more tiring. So nearer is better, but then nearer the less stable lah. So you find your comfort lah. So but this is about your front and all that, and then